Welcome to today's broadcast. God bless you. I'm reading from the Ephesians chapter 3 and verse number 18 in Amplified Classic. That you may have the power and be strong to apprehend and grasp with all the same God's devoted people the experience of that love. What is the breadth, the length, and the height, and the depth of it? Hallelujah. We saw at the beginning of the week that there is power in purity. And also yesterday, we saw that there is power in effectual fervent prayer. That if you are prayerful, you will be powerful. If you live in purity, you will be powerful. Today, the other secret that will unveil the power of God, that will make the power of God available in every area of your life, is the power of love. Hallelujah. That was what Jesus used in conquering the devil. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. It is the love of God that made him give Jesus. So the coming of Jesus and the death of Jesus was under the power of love. And of course, the Bible says it's the first and the biggest among the commandment of God that you shall love your neighbor as yourself. Here, this scripture is saying, if you want the power of God to be available for you, you have to be strong in your love life. Number one, strong in receiving the love from the Father. To know that God loves you beyond the devil hates you. Number two, you must learn to love God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your heart. That is responding to the love of God. And number three, you must learn how to love the brethren. So this scripture is saying you must apprehend and grasp with all the saints, God's devoted people, the experience of that love. Ability to love the unlovable. Learning how to forgive in the face of pain and hurt and difficult, but you let go. The way Jesus said it, forgive them for they know not what they are doing. God's love has a way of overwhelming your heart that you just overlook. And are you going to change them? No, but you can change the way you respond to them. And that gives you peace. You're not loving people for them. You're loving them for you. Because the power of God inside of you come to manifestation whenever the love of God is shared abroad in your heart. I'd like you to hear it from Jesus himself. In the book of John chapter number 15, verse number 12. This is my commandment, that ye love one another as I have loved you. Greater love hath no man than this, that a man lay his life for his friends. So sometimes you can lay a lot of things down for your friend, you know, and just obey the word of God so that you can be empowered. Most of the powerful people, prayerful, pure people, but difficult to forgive. Their power, what is in that in their life? Show me a man who can love and who is able to pray, who can live in purity. I'll show you a man of power. And then you say, he said, ye are my friend if you do whatsoever I command you. So the commandment of God for love is what God will want us to obey. God is calling us to love. The more you can love the brethren, love the people in your life, learn to forgive those who hurt you, the more power you enjoy. So power goes in the line of living your life in love. So God is calling you and calling me to love the Lord God, to love our neighbor as ourselves. Then you have to love yourself also. The more of living in love is more of living in power. God's power will always work where God's love is at work. I want you to write it under this video. Love before power. God bless you. Have a wonderful day.